Our next guest is a comedian, actress, producer, and TV personality. Now she's adding hosts to her resume with the release of her upcoming podcast. Please welcome Torrei Hart. Hey!
Hi!
Hey.
Hello! Thank you.
Okay, so speaking of looking all sensational and everything, recently you posted a picture up on your gram.
Okay.
And the comments were litty.
Ooh, yes.
All because of how fit and fabulous you look.
Amazing.
Talk to us about this life. How did you get in that great shape, by the way?
Well, you know what? I'm happy. Number one,
yes,
happiness.
There's that.
Number two, I started keto, which is a low, let me say, high fat, low carb diet. Right. Mm-hmm. And no sugar. You can't have any sugar. Yes. So, I mean, I know. If you like sugar, it's not for you.
As a carbaholic myself, I'm like, man, girl, that takes some willpower.
I think you tried it for like a day.
And I did not last.
Oh, a day, Adrienne?
Yeah, no, I need a bread.
Girl, okay.
It's terrible.
You need some of my recipes. That's what you need.
Okay, so what are some of them?
Yeah, so I have a recipe book called Skinny Bitch Keto. And and I'm in it, you know, it's just a play on the name. I just thought it was catchy. And so I have this garlic Tuscan chicken. If you like chicken, that's amazing. I have this Southern shakshuka, which is for vegetarians, which is really good. And then I have a lot of dessert recipes too. So, I mean, that's what I've been doing. And I spin, I hike, and
you look amazing.
Thank you.
Whatever you are doing, it is working. But I think the main thing you just said that spoke to me was happiness.
Yes.
You obviously co-parent with Kevin Hart, your ex.
Yes.
And what has that process been like?
Easy.
Talk about it, because
I think
there's
easy.
So many blended families out there that it's so great when you hear someone say,
the fact that you
it's
said
easy.
Easy.
It's easy. Yeah.
Pray tell.
So, and here's the funny thing. People just assume for whatever reason that me and Kevin are enemies. I don't know why. Me and Kevin, we go way back. We met when we were 19 and 20.
Wow.
So
kids.
We're like, we were kids, you know? And unfortunately, it didn't work out romantically. But, you know, now we just co-parent very well for the kids. We made a conscious decision to make sure that we want healthy, happy children. So it's about our kids. It is not about us.
Wow.
I mean, us didn't work out, but that don't mean we're gonna have our kids all in, you know, crazy situations and seeing mom and dad going through things. So it was just a decision for both of us, and we came to that agreement, and I mean, it's amazing.
To see you actually living that life. I have so much respect for you
on
that regard.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
And another thing, like a lot of us, actually we've talked about it here on the show, is how women who are no longer with their spouse, their partner, keep the last name. And you decided to keep Hart.
I did.
So walk us through that. Like, how was that decision for you?
Well, that's another thing. People, you know, negative people, should I say, because I don't really pay it no mind. But, I mean, I'm too positive and too busy enjoying my life to even focus on that. But, you know, me and Kevin also, you know, decided he had no issues with me changing my last name. And my children also said to me, Mom, we do not want you to change your last name.
Okay.
They wanted the same last name as me. And I said, okay, guys, I will keep the same last name as you. Because, you know, when you go to school sometimes and one parent has a different name, one parent has a different name, it's like the kid gets called to the office and it's like, oh, this is Johnson, but this is Hart. And it's like, that weighs on the child.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, it's not even another thing. It's not about me. It's not about Kevin. It's about our children and what they want. And one thing that we do well is make sure that our kids are happy and we listen to what they want.
Prioritize.
I hear that. I love that you say that you went through a breakup, but now you've gone through a breakthrough.
A breakthrough, yes.
What is the breakthrough? Tell us, and how can women get in on this breakthrough after a breakup?
Oh, yeah. So I went through a breakthrough, and let me tell you, it's not like it was all peaches and cream, because it wasn't. I mean, there was times where I was like, God, I don't want to be here anymore.
Wow.
Of course, yeah, because, you know, the divorce was very public, and I also had to watch him move on with a whole nother woman, and a whole nother family.
Yeah.
You know, so, and then seeing my children in pictures with, you know, a new family, you know, that it's, you know, most people when they go through divorce, you know, they don't have to see it like in their face like every day. Like, and this is when Kevin was like at the height of his career. So, you know, imagine I'm seeing it on the TV, I'm seeing it on movies, I'm seeing it, you know, played out on the internet. One time, girl, it was so bad that it was on the navigation system. He was in a movie called Ride Along, and the voice was him. So I'm like, oh my God.
How do I get away?
No right, way. Right.
So I'm like, God, okay, God, you are really playing some jokes on me. So I made a decision to stay happy. I made a decision to move all the way forward, let the past be the past, start on my new journey.
Yes.
And yeah, because, you know, like, I got a whole life ahead of me. Yes. Like, why am I worried about this? Like, a whole life ahead of me. Mm-hmm. So that's when I decided to have the breakthrough. Also, before the breakthrough, you know, I did hit a rough patch. And like I said before, me and Kevin are friends. I reached out to him for help. And he put me in touch with Ayanna Van Zandt, who became my personal therapist. And right, and she doesn't do therapy one-on-ones with anybody
she
anymore.
She was doing a one-on-one fix your life off the cameras.
Right, yes. Off the cameras.
Yeah.
That's part of the reason why I am having this big breakthrough.
Yeah.
And that's where Breakin Thru with Torrei came from, the podcast.
Yes, talk to us about that.
So another thing that a lot of people don't know about me is that I am an actress. I am a comedian myself. I do produce movies that are currently on BET and television right now.
That's so dope, and people may not know that, yeah.
They don't because they always choose to just focus on the fact that my ex-husband is Kevin versus what I bring to the table and what I've trained for years. So it always gets like swept under the rug, which sucks, you know? So it's a gift and a curse, you know? But Breakin Thru, somebody called me for a job, and somebody else who was working with this producer, they were like, oh, well, we don't know if we can work with her because of Kevin. It's like people are scared to work with me because of I'm like, me and Kevin are cool. That's my family. What are you scared of? So I called my girlfriend, Lori, who's actually backstage with me. She's a publicist, but, you know, she's my girlfriend.
Hey, Lori.
Lori. She does so much for me, and I love you, Lori. And I called her and I was like, I can't take it anymore. This is it's ridiculous. I'm like, I'm so talented. I got so many things going on, but people are scared because of Kevin. I was like, Lori, I can't take it. And I just started screaming. I was like, I need a breakthrough. Mm-hmm. And next thing I know, I was like, that's it. That is it. The podcast is Breakin Thru with Torrei. I said, because there's so many other people in life and situations, you know, even people who have certain jobs and they're just like, you know, I need to get to the next level. I need a breakthrough. It is really amazing. Flavor Flav is one of my, yes. And guys, and Flavor Flav gave his breakthrough moment on my podcast. He's sober now, so I was able.
Oh, wow.
Yes, sober, and yeah, clap it up for that. Yeah. Clap it up for sobriety, huge. Because that's not easy.
Not at all.
Especially when you know, you've been in the same habit for years.
Well, you're not just like stepping to the next level, you're leveling up, because you also have a new movie, Super Turnt.
Yes.
Tell us about that too, because you're throwing in all the hype.
Yes, look at it right there.
Super Turnt is, it's a movie that I'm actually an executive producer of and starring in with me, Jamal Woolard, who played Biggie in the Notorious B.I.G. movie, Harry Lennox from The Five Heartbeats, which is one of my favorite movies, and Blacklist and The Matrix goes on and on. And so it's I play Rita Robinson, who is a big-time record exec. Ooh. And yeah, and I'm the boss. I take no mess from nobody, and I'm going in there to secure deals for my clients and make things happen. But the underlying story of it is a young man who gets accused for a crime he didn't do. He ends up in jail, and he loses a deal, but he comes back out, and now he's fighting for his family and fighting to get his deal back. And I can't really go into it too much, because then I'll give everything away.
No.
But that's it, and that's with my partner, Man Robinson, out in Atlanta with Man Robinson Studios. We shot a lot of things there.
Amazing.
And so I'm
congratulations.
Really excited.
A lot going on. Well, Torrei, thank you so much for just hanging out with us today. We really appreciate it. Her new podcast, Breakin Thru with Torrei Hart, launches today. And also be sure to catch her new film, Super Turnt, which premieres tomorrow, October 16th.